The name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Jesus does not know window dressing. Pag sinabi nating window dressing, it is the skillful but sometimes superficial or actually misleading presentation, something designed to create favorable impression. Para bang pinapaganda mo. Pero sa totoo, pag nandyan na, mahirap na. There's a paradigm shift in welcoming would-be followers, especially for Jesus. Diba pag nag-iimbita ka, kaya may business ka, come here, okay dito, very easy, kayang-kaya nyo, it will be very pleasant. But they don't talk about your responsibility, especially sa sales and marketing. Magaling po dyan yung packaging, maganda yung kulay, talagang you will be attracted. But mayroong mga hidden charges or mga hidden responsibilities they don't talk about. But Jesus from the very beginning wanted His disciples to be coping with their own capabilities and to build their own resilience. Parang yung mga parents, yung mga magulang, they want their children to be emotionally strong. The young will be determined and be able to solve their problems, if not later on the problem of other people. To have the courage to step out beyond their comfort zone and to face reality as it is. Jesus did not hide anything from His followers. He said from the very beginning, it is not easy. Gusto niyong sumama sa akin? Hindi walk in the park. Hindi magaan. No window dressing to attract your attention or to say it's very easy in a way. Parang pag nag-aaral yung mga anak po ninyo. Tell them, anak, gusto mo mag-engineer. Talaga, it's not easy. You really have to be patient. Engineering, pwedeng maraming barkada dyan, but you have to make a choice. 5 years yan, anak. Pag may nag-graduate na sila, sabihin mo, anak, when you make a living, it's not also easy. Huwag kang maghanap ng buhay na parang dumarating na lang pera. Hindi ganyan. You really have to work for it. Even marriage, even parenting, it's not easy. Bago mo desisyon, dapat kang mag-isip, lalo na sa mga kabataan ngayon. Even serving the Lord, it's not that easy. It may be very ideal, but the truth is, sometimes we have our own cloud nine imagination na parang everything will be well, pero hindi man. Nung pumasok po kami sa seminaryo, nung high school po ako, after high school. Of course, yung pagpapasok ka sa seminaryo, parang mayroon kang imagination that everything is holy, everything is divine, everything is kind and beautiful. Siguro, pero along the way, makita mo sa seminaryo, mahirap din pala yung pag-aaral doon. Kailangan kang magpuyat, mag-aral ng leksyon. Kasabay ng pag-aaral, ang pagdarasal, sports, and other community obligations. Sa seminaryo pala, meron din nag-aaway. Meron din nagsusuntukan. Meron din an ideal situation. Parang when we entered the seminary, parang sinasabi nung director namin noon, welcome to reality. Na pumasok ka dito, when you follow Christ, you must be willing to take reality as itself. It's not easy. Sabi nga, no pain, no gain. No guts, no glory. Sabi naman ng security guard, no ID, no entry. Nabiro lang po yan. Pero siguro sa mga kabataan ngayon, parang sinasabi ni Jesus sa inyo, it's not a promise that it will be everything pleasant or easy in your life in following me. He said it very blatantly and plainly. If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself. Kailangan nakandahang kalimutan mo ng sarili mo. Hindi yung me, ako, sa akin. You cannot follow Christ if you have that attitude. You have to take up your cross. Hindi lang paminsan-minsan, daily, araw-araw. And then you have to follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. And whoever loses his life, for my sake, saves it. What profit is there for one to gain the whole world and yet lose or forfeit himself? Parang kailangan mong gustong makamit ang grasya ng Diyos. Hindi po basta-basta. He does not promise any false expectation or misleading invitations. Parang ito yung sinasabi niya sa kanyang mga alagad kasi alam niya darating yung araw when they are on their own in mission, they will also face a lot of challenges. Meron po isang international boxing champion, taga Ukraine po siya. Parang sa atin, kung meron tayong Manny Pacquiao, sa Ukraine meron din po silang Alexander Usyk. Malaking ano po ito, ang kanyang boxing title heavyweight. Si Pacquiao medyo lower. Champion siya ng boxing, international. Mayaman siya, siyempre. Pero alam niyo po, nung nagkaroon ng gera sa Ukraine, umuwi po siya. I think nagtitraining siya sa Amerika or London. Umuwi siya. Okay na po siya, mayaman. Safe na siya sa ibang bansa. Sikat na siya. Pero he went home. 1 year na alos yun. And I would like to quote him once again. More than a year na yung gera sa Ukraine. Sabi niya, my soul belongs to the Lord, but my body and my honor to my country. Tignan niyo po yan. Ang kaluluwa ko sa Diyos, pero ang aking katawan, ang aking karangalan sa aking bansa. Maybe it sounds all sentimental, but he said, but my soul belongs to the Lord and my body and my honor belongs to my country and my family. So there is no fear, absolutely no fear, sabi niya. As a refugee, he flee Ukraine and volunteers to return home to fight. More than 1 million people fled Ukraine. Some Ukrainian volunteers were traveling on the opposite side, returning to their country to join the ranks to defend their own country. On the other hand naman, kabaligtaran po sa Russia, there are signs that Russians and even Russian soldiers express disagreement with the war and against the violence in Ukraine. Parang sinasabi nila, Russians struggle to understand the Ukraine war. Sabi niya, because we did not choose this. Pwede sigurong leader nila, gusto may gusto sa gera, pero kami hindi namin gusto ang gera. They were forced to follow. And yet there is no determination. Malaki pong pagkakaiba yan. When you are fighting and you are willing to die because you believe in what you do. Therefore, yung mga kahirapan na diraras, kasama na yan. It's a choice and a decision to follow Jesus. The question, the priest, pag kinakasal, may kinasal po ako kanina, alas 3. Tapos meron ding golden wedding, 4:30. It's the same question. Did you come here out of your own free will? To bind yourself forever in the love and service of your wife or husband? Sasabihin, yes, Father. To be there out of free will. And this is also the way we follow Christ. A leader does not force his people to follow him, yet he invites them on a journey. And the journey is not expected to be pleasant. Hindi lang po joyride ang pagiging Kristiyano. There's no pain reliever or anything that will make us numb in discipleship. Like the sorrows of Mary, the martyrdom of many saints. Parang in a business, if there are challenges like the pandemic na pinagdaanan natin, and nandito pa ngayon, pagkatapos ng pandemya, yung business mo nandito pa, gusto sabihin, you are able to withstand the difficult challenges of the past almost 2 years. Sabi nga ni Bo Sanchez, nagka-COVID din po si Bo Sanchez last year eh. Talagang ilang araw siya sa hospital. And then after surviving COVID and so much pain, sabi po ni Bo Sanchez, you will come out stronger. We're not praying that life will be difficult. O gusto natin maging mahirap yung buhay ng ating kabataan, ng anak ninyo at pamangkin. Pero if they have to, and they must, to be able to realize their capacity to be strong beyond their comfort zone. Halos magsa-summer na po, di ba? Summer na halos. Mainit na rin. Alam niyo po, meron akong favorite na bulaklak. Hindi po yung mamahaling bulaklak na imported. Though magaganda din po yun. O yung mga orchids na maganda rin po. Meron po tayong local na bulaklak. It shows our understanding of Christianity. At sana ang mga anak po ninyo, tayo lahat, maging kamukha nila. They thrive on neglect. They survive the heat and even dryness of summer. Nagtataka ako pag mainit, lalo silang namumulaklak. Kahit makalimutan mo silang lagyan ng tubig, they still bloom. Kahit hindi mo sila mapansin, pero they continue to thrive. But they know how to protect themselves. Meron po silang protection. Meron silang mga thorns. No? Alam niyo po ito, yung bonggabilya. Yung mga bonggabilya po, natural dito sa Pilipinas. Kung gusto niyo magkaroon ng bulaklak na hindi po heavy duty in terms of maintenance, but they give you beautiful flowers, especially the heat of summer, mga bonggabilya halimbawa dyan. I think our Christian life must be like this also. There are times we are neglected, hindi tayo pinapansin. We are not taken care, hindi tayo inaaruga. Bisan mainit na mainit, we are deprived of scarcity, walang-walang tubig, but we continue to thrive and even later on to bloom with beautiful flowers. Let this be our invitation. Christianity and following Christ, there are no window dressing. But when you really experience the love of God, like the bonggabilya, the beautiful part of your person and the beautiful life of a Christian will bloom in you and through you. May God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Please.